in Germany, in Berlin, we brew beers without hops. Trust Germans, this is very innovative in a way, because we are a hops country and we have beers only with hops. Otherwise, you are not allowed to call it beer. So the innovative thing is to actually question this by showing that it's possible to also brew beers with other herbs that we have been used before the Reinheitsgebot. We have a purification law in Germany. And with our ingredients, we show that it's possible to get a foam, to get a tasteable, pleasant beer. And to bring also people who don't like beer to drinking beer. That's the idea.
Now, what do you consider your most innovative beers?
The most all of them, because they don't have hops in it. It's all the innovation side on the whole thing. They are all, because they don't have hops, they are not calming you down. The hops effect is it calms you down. So they are more arising spirits. You don't get tired out of them. It's more from the effect, it's more like a Prosecco. So you are high in spirits. And we have different flavors. The most innovative thing where we use the most herbs is the Schwarze Schaf. And some people are telling me they don't like it at all because it tastes like medicine. And others say it's great stuff because it's so unusual. So that's because we call it Schwarze Schaf means black sheep. That's the idea of, you know, introducing herb. So that's why I found a workaround called Gibroy. This is allowed. I'm not allowed to say I'm brewing in Germany because in Germany we brew only beer and beer has hops. That's the logic behind it. So I'm producing an alcoholic drink which is close to a beer.